If you wish to learn how to open files using Python in simple English, this video will help you. In this series of tutorials on Python programming in simple English, we focus on files. We start with a simple text file called myfile.txt. We want to open this file and print the contents. So we use the term open, we have the file name, quotes, and then we use a for loop to print each line of text. We use this variable fh. Do we need to use fh? No, we can use any name we like. So in this example, we've called it another name. But we've achieved the same thing. We've printed all of the text. So what is this fh or another name? It's called a file handle. And you don't really need to understand everything about this. You can just use it. But if you wish to understand, it's something that just points to the place in the file, and then it moves through your text and reads the text. That's a file handle. We print each line, but something's happened. There's a gap between each line. There's a reason for that. When you look inside the file, you'll see there's three lines of text, but the computer sees something different. It's continuous, but there's something in between each line. There's this backslash n. If we look at that, you can see that what the computer does, it reads in the text and then has a symbol that tells it it's a new line. That's a new line symbol, this backslash n. So what can we do? When we get our data, when we use the for loop, we can use strip that takes out this new line character. That's better. Now we can look at our text and there's no gaps. So how do we open other types of files? And how do we send our data out into files? Well, we can use the same method to open different types of files. So if you want to open a web file, which is .htm or HTML, or a comma separated value file, which is .csv, we can use exactly the same code. When we're writing data out to a file, so rather than getting text from a file, we're putting text into a file, we can write to a file. And here we use similar syntax, similar Python, but when we open, we use the letter W for write. So now Python knows we want to write the text from our program out to a file. So here we open the file, then we write the text, and then we close the file. Be very careful. Python will look for this file name, and if it exists, it will delete everything inside it and overwrite that. So whatever you want to put in will be the new file, and whatever happened before, whatever text was in there before, is completely gone. If the file doesn't exist, it will create a new file. So you can see in this example, we open our output file, then we have a string number 7, and we can write to that text, and then close. And that will create the outfile.txt file with just the number 7 inside it. Or if the outfile.txt exists already, it will delete everything inside it, and now we just have a new file with that number 7 in. Again, be careful. Everything you print to a file has to be a string. So in the example we have with number 7, if we had that as an integer, we would get this error message. So what we need to do is change this integer 7 to a string. So you can see my num is now a string before we put it into the output file. So far, we've used a simple example. But if you look on the web, you will see there are different methods to read in data. For example, we can open a file and instead of writing to it using a W, we can use A, which stands for append. So this means when we open the output file, we will add on the text to what text exists already. So that's append. When we're getting data from a file, we can use open, but also there's a command called read, and this reads all of the text from the file and puts it into memory, which sometimes is not a good thing. So we prefer using the simple open and the for loop method. You may see other syntax, for example using the word with. So this is exactly the same. You have with open file as file handle, and then the for loop using strip to get rid of the new line character. And the advantage of this method is it closes the file automatically. What happens if the file you're opening isn't in the same place as your Python file? For example, you may have a folder and the file's in that. So in this example, the file is just in a folder called my folder. You change the address when you use open, or if you want to use the whole address called the path on your computer, then you can use that to open the file. So there's two methods there. If the file's in a different place than where you're running the Python file. Okay, in this video, the quiz is different. You have one task. To start off your task, create the text file, myfile.txt, with these three lines of text in the file. Your task is to open this text file, strip the unwanted characters from each line of text, put the words into a list, then using this list put the words into a dictionary as the keys, and the value will be the count of how many times each word occurs in the text. The result of this dictionary you want to put into a new text file. So the new text file has each word and how many times that word occurs. So your output's going to look like this. You're going to have a list of words and how many times they occurred. So the words this, the, line, from, and file occurred three times. The word first, second, and third occurred once, and the word the occurred six times. Okay, now we look at the answer to the quiz. First part, we open a file, which we use the Python in this lesson. The second part, we add the text together in the for loop. So we use here all text equals all text plus line, and then we spit this text into a list called my list. We use a for loop to go through each value in the list, and then we use that to put it into a dictionary and we count how many times the word used. We use the dot get function for that. Part 4, we need to print it to an output file. So we use the W in the open function. We're going to use another for loop with the dictionary dot items, And here you can see the text. We've got the key X plus a space, and then we're going to change the number to a string. So Y is an integer, and we're changing that to a string, and then we're going to use a new line character. Now all of that's a text, that's like one line, a string that's one line that was going to the output file. We're going to add this line into all text again. So all text is going to be all of the text from the dictionary, and then that one string, we're going to write it to the output file before we close the output file. So if we put all of the parts together, the syntax, over three slides, you can see we open the file, we add all the text together, split it into a list, then we create the dictionary that counts the words, and then we open the output file, we make sure the number is a string, and then we print it, we write it to the output file. So do you think this would work with web pages? Why not try it, see what happens? It would be great to see some comments. And if you haven't already, please remember to subscribe. Thank you.